So Laura, thank you so much for getting me your lesson plan. I've looked over it, and I'm glad we have some time between now and when you're going to teach it. It's Monday today, and you're going to be teaching this lesson on Thursday,
Yes.
correct? Good. So I have some questions for you
Okay.
about this, and I want to get some kind of insight from you as to how we can improve this so that when you teach this on Thursday, it's ready to go.
Okay.
So my first question for you is, what is the overall objective of this lesson? I noticed that you have the physical science evidence outcome, but in looking over this, I don't really see a very concise objective for this lesson.
So, one of the Colorado academic standards for sixth grade physical science is that atoms may stick together in well-defined molecules or be packed together in large arrays. Different arrangements of atoms into groups compose all substance. It's important for students to have an understanding of the notion of valence electrons, the outer electrons of an atom, because it's the valence electrons that ultimately are involved in bringing atoms together. So that's the overall goal, is to make sure that they really understand valence electrons. Ultimately, I'd love to push them into the fact that when you look at a periodic table, based on placement in a periodic table, you can know what the number of valence electrons are. I'm a little worried how much I can get them to see the trend and get them to the overall trend and the valence electrons and connecting it to the periodic table. I'm not sure if I have enough time. So that may come in another lesson. But today they've really absolutely, after they finish this lesson or on Thursday, not today, understand what a valence electron is and how it is involved in bringing atoms together.
Okay, so you have an objective then. You really want your students to know what a valence electron is and how it brings, what did you say?
It
Brings
brings atoms together.
atoms together. Okay, so that's your objective. So when I look at this, we got to buy some time to accomplish that. So if I'm looking at your warm up, can you kind of explain to me what you want to do with your warm up here? And how and as you talk about your warm up, how does that fit with your objective? Everything in your lesson plan, I really want to ensure that it's geared towards.
It goes back to the objective. All right. So my warm up is when students arrive, I want them to draw a sketch of an atom and label the parts, and make sure they include the charges just to ensure that they get coming in the door that the electrons are outside of the nucleus.
Okay, so that's an assessment, would you say?
It's a quick check for understanding. I believe that they should know
So
this. And
you've taught this before. So do you have a plan for if you have kids that don't get it? What would that
And
be?
if they don't get it, then my prediction is maybe only two. So this is really to see if I've got to go there with those two or they have an understanding of it. What I have ready for them is if their sketch that they put down into their notebook is not what it needs to be, and I do plan to circulate around while they're
Okay,
doing this.
good.
I have already prepared a little proper diagram so that I can give someone who misses the proper diagram and say, I'm going to ask you right now to go ahead and use this today to remind yourself of the structure, and we're going to come back to this so I can keep them moving.
Good. Excellent. I didn't see that on this lesson plan. I'd like to see something on the
Okay,
lesson plan.
so add in the piece about the support.
And when you're thinking along those lines, support for the kids that don't get it, and then really, what are you going to be doing for the kids that did it quick? Okay, so then you move into your mini lesson, and something I see here is copying notes during a PowerPoint. Is that the best way to have the kids really get this information? Or could we think of something that would be a bit more engaging and informative to the kids?
They are copying, aren't they?
And so copying, they're just going to be copying notes from a PowerPoint given to them. That's not very interactive. They're not really engaging with the material. They're just copying. What could we do to really get them to understand valence electrons?
Well, there's a section in the text that talks about valence electrons. I guess one of the things that I always get a little nervous about is I find myself doing things to avoid them reading the book.
Yeah.
And this is bad, I think, because ultimately, you know, they're in sixth grade now. Mm-hmm. They're going to have to continue to read nonfiction. But exactly. I always find myself figuring out a way not to have them read it, because what if they get stuck?
Yeah.
So it'd be easier, honestly, for me if they could use the book mm-hmm. and read about valence electrons.
Yeah.
But I'm not sure I know how to, and it's in the text. I didn't bring my textbook with me. I should have brought that. There's two pages that it lays out, mm-hmm. And it's got a nice diagram.
Mm-hmm.
So really what I need is some sort of almost a little structured piece to take them through that text. Yes. And they could maybe pull the information out themselves.
Yes.
Okay.
So let's think about that, because okay. that would, I think you're on the right path there.
Okay.
Just giving them the information doesn't really serve the purpose.
Okay.
And I like your thoughts about having them actually read nonfiction.
Okay.
And get information from that. So that's something that we want to really think about, is how could we do this in a more kind of structured way that allows them to actually get the information they need themselves and not be given the okay. information.
Because they you know, can put that then into their science notebook.
Exactly.
So they've got the notebook going.
Yeah.
Okay, so let me take a look at the piece of text.
Mm-hmm.
And figure out. The other thing is I may work with one of the literacy coaches then.
Yes.
And have them take a look at it and say, any
that's
ideas?
That's exactly right.
Okay.
That's exactly right. That's great for that transdisciplinary, interdisciplinary kind of connection.
Okay.
So really good.
Okay. So then I still think that it's going to take probably about 20 minutes.
Yes.
Because I'll have to transition them into getting the book out.
Mm-hmm.
And then getting the information out and then doing some sort of sharing to make sure we have correct information.
Yes.
So I think we're still at about 20 minutes.
Yes.
But I agree that would be more engaging than having them copy.
And I think that if you look at your third step here,
uh-huh.
you could merge those two together. You're going to move into a think, pair, share, think, write, pair, share.
Uh-huh.
And I'm assuming, again, your lesson plan doesn't really go into detail about this, but
uh-huh.
my assumption in reading this is that the think, write, pair, share, in which they write three sentence summaries of the key concepts from their notes, could be connected to...
Oh, so, and that was the intent, that I would give them the notes, but there I'm giving the information. And then, okay, so, and then they would write a three sentence summary from those notes. So instead, have them extract the notes themselves.
Exactly.
Okay, and then do... a think, write, pair, share from those notes.
Exactly.
And then that's how we can share the information and
yes.
make sure that it's ready. I think, honestly, if I put those two together, I could probably save 5 minutes here.
Without a doubt.
Okay.
I think so, because they're completely and totally connected.
So really this, that my think, write, pair, share could become the check for understanding
yes.
for the reading activity.
Exactly.
Okay.
As well as your kind of intro on valence electrons.
Right? Okay.
So, I mean, we're cutting some time right
okay.
there.
So I'm going to put these together and call it 25.
Yes.
Okay.
And I really like your idea of having them use the text
mm-hmm.
because we get away from that too
I do.
Often.
I do. You know what I call it? I do text workarounds
yeah.
because I'm scared that they won't be able to read the text. But I guess at the end of the day, if I keep working around the text, they'll never read the text.
Exactly. And they'll learn that they don't have to.
Well, that's a good point.
So then that leads me to activity four here,
mm-hmm.
which is your electron activity, which mm-hmm. I really like. However, we could really cut some time from this.
What are you seeing?
I'm looking at you, the groups getting in four
right.
and cutting stuff out.
Uh-huh.
I'm unclear again exactly what they're going to be cutting out. But could you avoid the cutting and actually give them something they can work with? That would really cut some time down as well.
So what they would get is a sheet of paper
mm-hmm.
That has an atom on it
mm-hmm.
and then different atoms. Well, actually, it just needs to be one atom.
Mm-hmm.
And then, well, it'll have to be different atoms. But then they'll cut out little electrons, and so they would model, you know, like, for example, chlorine
mm-hmm.
and the fact that it's got, you know, X number of valence
mm-hmm.
electrons, or hydrogen and how many valence electrons it has. But you're right. They already know how to cut.
They
I don't need to watch them cut.
And that takes a lot of time.
Hmm.
So if we could think about an activity that would be really hands-on, but really have them show, remember, we want to go back to that lesson objective. Mm-hmm. We really want them to know what a valence electron is and how it's connected. Mm-hmm. What could we do that would really have them show that? Because if we look through this process, they've read about it. They've mm-hmm. done a think, pair, share about it. Right. They know about it. Now they need to show it.
Right. And that's what this is about, because I can walk around mm-hmm. and look at their models. Mm-hmm. And then it begins to transition them into the bonding mm-hmm. and how the valence electrons fall into that.
I mean, we could do a little upfront work and have the cutting and all of the materials already done. So it's at the table, and then they can just do the work.
But you know what? It really doesn't have to be. It just needs to be something that could represent an electron. So mm-hmm. it could even be a kidney bean. Yeah. I mean, it could be a dried bean. Or maybe I could get, I think the math department has some little chips that they use. Mm-hmm. So I could even use chips. I mean, I could even use pennies for that matter. Exactly. And then the sheet of paper, rather than having them cut out, I could actually just have a sheet of paper that has on it the atoms that I want them to do. Mm-hmm. So maybe that they're going to do sodium, that they're going to do chlorine, that they're going to do oxygen, that they're going to do hydrogen. Yeah. And I could line them up because, you know, sodium and chlorine come together to be sodium chloride. Exactly. So I could strategically put these on the page together. Mm-hmm. I think also then some of my higher end kids might naturally then go, oh, sodium and chlorine, I've heard of sodium chloride, and then see the pattern. Yeah. So if I put them on the page like this, and then they just used, I kind of like the idea of using beans because it's smaller than pennies. Yeah, that's and they a good put idea. The beans around them. What do you think?
I like that idea a lot.
And then I could just have beans in the middle and they're ready to go.
And that cuts down on the time that you had budgeted for this significantly.
Yeah, a lot. It gives me more time to transition them into how they share the electrons. Yep. And then for anybody that quickly catches on to how they share, I could transition them into, I could make sure that I include some repeats on where these things fall into the periodic table. So to see if they could make the link between the placement in the periodic table and the valence electrons. So that would allow me to kind of move this and have some differentiation built in.
And it would. And we talked before at the beginning of this discussion about your objective, and that was your ultimate goal. That was the big goal, is how it all connects to the periodic table. Right. And there you have time to do that with those kids that are ready to do that. Hmm.
So I'm almost wondering, do I leave the activity at 25 minutes and see how far we can take it? Because I think if I line it out, kind of stage mm-hmm. what I put on the paper and how I have them work, it might kind of mold the thinking into seeing these trends and the patterns.
I think that's a great idea.
Okay. Now, let me ask you this. I have them in fours. Mm-hmm. Is my group too big? Because one of the things that I see when I have fours mm-hmm. is I notice that sometimes I get observers. Mm-hmm. So I'm wondering if maybe, since I don't need to worry about numbers of scissors anymore and all that, maybe I should just put them in pairs.
If that's what you've seen in the past and if that's what you're thinking, I think go with that. And okay. Let's see how that works. Okay. I like that idea, and I like your thinking on this. I like you reflecting on what you've seen in the past mm-hmm. and what you'd like to see in this lesson. Mm-hmm. So let's try the two. I like that idea and see how that works.
Okay. And then now I'm feeling like, because I might take them further, mm-hmm. my exit card, do you think it's okay to do an exit card as my closure?
You know, on your exit card, you wanted them to write down two things that they're certain about in regards to valence electrons, and write down one question you have about valence electrons. My question to you would be, do you feel that through this activity, through this whole lesson, and based on your objective, that's still what you want to see?
I do, but what I'm worried about is it's that my hope mm-hmm. would be that my students that took this as far as they possibly could are going to write down two higher level mm-hmm. things, but they may not, and I may not push that. So I think I need to rethink my exit card so I can be sure that if they got as far as mm-hmm. what is the trend, in the periodic table with respect to valence electrons, that I know that I get that out of them, because a kid could fulfill my what I've laid out as the expectations by just saying that valence electrons are the outer electrons. And that could be one of their things, and that's a pretty So I need to restructure this. I'm going to have to think about that a little bit.
Because in our discussion, what I've really seen come out is some really solid differentiation. And you know, for a first-year teacher as you are, that's the hardest thing, is to really ensure that you're differentiating your instruction for all the different levels in your class. And I don't know, from my perspective, it seems like you've done a really good job now in this discussion as to really ensuring that that's taking
place. Well, you know, Jeb, the thing that's happening when we're discussing my lesson is I'm now going back through it. So I think I wrote it, and now we're going back through it, and we're kind of almost auditing it. It's like, so are we really tied to the objective? Does everything hit the objective? Is it always engaging? And I think what I didn't do after I wrote it was to go back through and audit it. So it's been helpful to have you kind of walk me through an audit of my lesson. What I'd like to do is rework this and send it back to you again. Maybe if I could give it to you tomorrow.
That would be great.
Would that work?
That would be great, because then that would give us some more time to talk about this before you teach it on Thursday.
That'd be great.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Laura. All right.
Thank you.